Last time on El Niño in the case of the missing sardines. Something fishy is afoot in the tropical Pacific. Detective Rossby is on the case, trying to track down the missing marine life. A mysterious stranger has provided a tip.
Good to Walker, Mr. Rossby. If you want to find out what is happening to the fish, you need to ask her about El Niño.
What is El Niño?
I didn't know who to trust, but Walker was my best lead. If that dame was reeling me into a trap, I was falling for it hook, line, and sinker.
Ever heard of knocking?
Sorry, I hear you're the one to talk to about El Niño.
Where'd you hear that name?
Don't ask the question.
Tell me, Mr.
Detective Rossby.
Tell me, Mr. Rossby. What do you know about the tropical Pacific?
Here it's warm and wet.
Actually, there is a considerable change in temperature and precipitation from the west to the east. This temperature difference encourages the air above it to circulate. Here, observe this simple demonstration. In this demonstration, we are heating the bottom of the terrarium unevenly. Here there are cool rocks, and here there is warm water. Air rises over the warm water. This air then travels along the top of the terrarium until it hits the ice cubes. There, it cools and sinks back down, forming a circulation.
So this Walker circulation, is this what's happening in the tropical Pacific?
Correct, Mr. Rossby. Warm air rises over the West Pacific and sinks over the cooler waters in the East Pacific. Rising and sinking causes differences in air pressure. And because air likes to flow from high pressure to lower pressure, this strengthens the east to west winds at the surface. Higher up in the atmosphere, the wind blows from west to east, completing the circulation.
Okay, but what does this Walker circulation have to do with fish?
Fish?
How does this El Niño thing explain what's happening with the fish?
Oh, if you want to learn about the rest of the El Niño system, you're going to need to speak with Dr. Bjerknes.
Bjerknes?
Last I heard, Bjerknes was working on a side project with Anthony Chovy. Perhaps if you find one, you'll find the other.
Anthony Chovy, you say? Now that is interesting.
Perhaps your fish are related.
I'm sure they are. My time was running out, and Walker's circulation just didn't add up. Walker's lead brought me to Anthony Chovy's fish plant, and I had to talk to Bjerknes fast. Staying too long at this joint meant swimming in dangerous waters.